IMS, as you all know, is also working so hard facilitating funds and helps. And himself is also regularly goes to assist the situation in Syria. And subhanAllah, despite of all the difficulties and the trouble, they still manage to be able to communicate with us. And I think this is a clear message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we're still hearing their voices and we're hearing their calls. I mean, a long time ago, if anything happened or anything happened across the globe, it would go unnoticed. And you can easily say, I never heard about it. But subhanAllah Rabbi al-Azim, al-Hujjah qa'iman, we hear them talking to us. They're pleading, they're asking, they're calling for our help. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enable us to help them to the best of our abilities. Next session, we have Dr. Maher Shakir, Jazallah Khair, came all the way from Edmonton. Sattar, عفوا يا اسف انا سمعت شاكر من حد ما بعرف مين قرات سطار بس في حدا قال شاكر سامحني يا سيدي دكتور ماهر سطار شاكر سطار all the way from Edmonton جزاه الله خير يعني دكتور ماهر he lives in Edmonton works as a neurologist at the University of Alberta دكتور ماهر سطار يعني سبحان الله again look at the facilitation of technology is still able to help remotely. So just the ability to be able to treat victims and assist in treating remotely via inspection of CT scans and what have you on your laptop. So help could come in different forms. If you can't be there physically, you can help with your, again, expertise and knowledge remotely using the technology that we have, spending a lot of time at that front, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from him without further ado.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you for this honor introductions. And it's my pleasure to be Maher Shakir. I mean, Dr. Anas Shakir, Dr. there, and mashallah, Dr. Abul Hassan. Mashallah, they are the founders of FUSM, which is a part of it. Just gonna go quickly because I have just 10-15 minutes just to cover this. I have many slides. I just apologize if you're gonna be late. Just so this presentation is on the behalf of the CRS group, on the behalf of USM. Any project we do it through USM. We are a non-profit organization, mainly medical relief organizations. As you can see, we work in a close proximity with different charity organizations, mainly Human Concern International, ICNA, and Life for Relief and Development. We run through all the communities of Canada, across all Canada. This is our achievement in 2013, started by medical supply, to medical containers, to building hospitals, building trauma hospitals, rehab centers, and sending volunteer physicians, supporting physicians on the other end in Syria, in the surrendered area, primary care centers, and lately the tele-ICU, tele-psychiatry, and tele-neurology. Just quickly, that's skipping over the 2013, just our financial statement and what we sent. And the first half of 2014, I mean, Toronto, quite a bit generous, really, in this year. Over 400,000, 200,000, 220,000 has been used in East Ghouta, South Damascus for our medical warehouse where Abu Kinan, Dr. Abu Kinan was. And another 200 on its way, inshallah. Hopefully they will cover, that will cover their winter. Ottawa contribute, Alberta we contribute, and Vancouver contribute quite often, just a second. From medical container to all these things. We started by building rehab centers. We have two rehab centers, one in Rehania in collaboration with our colleagues in USM, and another one we support in Dara. And that's received the post-op care and the injured patients, children, and all over. In addition, we are the co-founder of, Dr. Anas can mention that. It's probably the biggest hospital now in Syria, in the northern borders. Bab al-Hawa Hospitals, and it's a four-level trauma treasury center. It's over 90 beds, 8 ORs, and I think it's more than 90 beds, I think it's 120 beds now, and 8 ORs, for emergency ORs and for subspecialty OR. We build up the first blood bank there in northern Syria that supplied all the northern part. The hemodialysis unit for renal failure patients there. We just opened the eye center there in collaborations with our colleagues in UK, our brothers in UK and in US and in France. Not only we didn't leave the children, a lot of injured children, so we opened pediatric surgery sections. Pediatric surgery over the last 2 months. And as you can see, the number of patients starts by 18. Now we have over 2,000 patients in a month. And that's the start of, like over the last months, the start. As you can see, we do on average like 240 surgery, subspecialty surgery, and emergency 222. And that's just male, female, and children. And we see on average 1,200 cases of emergency. Not only this, it's a center for education. Dr. Raphael and Dr. David Knott, there where they can teach paramedics, they teach physicians how they can take care of patients. Not only this, in the north side, we contribute to this beautiful hospital in East Volta. It's the central hospital, and we run it there. Now, we moved further, and the new things that we started with the creative minds, mashallah, in Toronto, they started creating or just developing equipment in a cheap price. It can replace the high expensive equipment there. That's one of what's called the vacuum. It's called vacuum assistance closure, just for cleaning wounds. Very cheap. It costs $5 to $10. The equal equipment, which is cost probably like around $1,000, $500 to $1,000. This is from our group in Toronto. Now, our group in BC, biomedical engineering, the orthopedic drill is very expensive, difficult to find in Syria. They came with this very simple models that can function as good as the orthopedic drill. It costs like $200. The new one, the medical one, it costs like around $2,000 and has been tried in 2 hospitals with excellent results. So neurology clinics, EMG clinics, psychiatrist, Dr. Salim, excellent work, and he started the psychiatry program. Dr. Hussam started the dental programs there. So we work all in a group. We try to cover as much as we can. Now, lately, just we have been doing tele-ICU. We cover at least 5 centers in the northern Syria of telemedicine, where we have a physicians here, monitor patient there, and treat patient there in ICU, psychiatry, and neurology. We get medical volunteers from all over the world, and we go with them, and we advocate for medical volunteering just to give a little bit of break for the physician there in Syria. Not only this, that gets us to know great physicians from all over the world. You just listened to Dr. Raphael. He built up his team, excellent. He has been all over Syria. Dr. David Knott, I recommend that you listen to his CBC his record, excellent one. What impressed me, he said that, he didn't get married, he didn't have children, so when he go to the war zone, he has nothing to worry about. God's sake, Abu Hisham and me, we have 5 kids. And Dr. Suhail is an excellent one. I have a chance to work with him 3 times. So what do we need? We need to cover all these projects. We need to cover Bab al-Hawa, Bab al-Hawa Hospital, East Ghouta Hospital. We need to fill up our medical supply, the primary care centers, and we need to supply these physicians inside with a salary, with a minimum salary of $300, $400 a month to keep them there. The problem that we are facing lately, that the physicians are very, very much leaving the areas. You don't blame them. This is number 4 years, So medical warehouse, we have a medical warehouse all over Syria, in East Ghouta, South Damascus, Daraa, and we used to have one in Qalamon, and in all the northern Syria, and we supply with medical supply. through CRS and through all our organization in USIM. The Bab el Hawa Hospital, the biggest one in the northern side, we need 10,000 a month just to run it from our part. The East Ghouta Hospital, another major hospital in the surrendered area, we cannot let it be down. We need to keep running. The primary care centers, our colleagues and our brothers in France, Dr. Banana, started this excellent project, and we gave him hand in that. That these primary centers treat obstetrics, TB, Leishmania, name it. All these contagious diseases treated in these primary centers all across the country. And as I said, doctors running, going away, we need to keep supporting them with a small amount, which is how much we paid. We paid $400 a month to keep them there. There is, you know, there's no financial support. Now, I'm going to present you these two cases just to give you an idea of what we face and what the people there face. This is in the day of Eid, by the way. This is my kids. These are my three daughters. You know, I put that in contrast here. I remember Dr. Anas was in Aleppo that day. You know, and we have Rua. Rua was on the swing. Am I right, Wisham? On the swing, and suddenly she fell off the swing. I remember this case, like this is the first day of Eid al-Adha. My kid was very well prepared for Eid. I have Rua, I saw her through tele ICU, through the computer. You know, her family said, you know, she just fell off the swing. She's probably a small one there. I discussed the case with the doctor, and she said, it's impossible. She's comatose, she's not responding, she's not following commands. See, we agreed, let's do x-ray. We did an x-ray. We found a bullet in her head. So what happened while she was on the swing, a bullet hit her head. She never wake up. What made the story very sad, SubhanAllah, Abu Hisham and I, we were discussing what we will do next. We need to do CAT scan, just give her a chance. You know, chance of survival. Like just in case something can be done for her from neurosurgical perspective. You know, the disaster part is the most sad part, that there is no CT scan in Aleppo at that minute. So her parents insist on taking her to the regime area in Aleppo. And the last thing I heard that her parents got captured. So another thing, just I want to point it here. Excellent physician, Dr. Hussam. He was working in Saraqib Hospital. And Saraqib Hospital got bombarded 4 months ago. And he, subhanAllah, we lost him. He died. He's a friend and his brothers, whom we have a chance to work with him, Dr. Abul Bara. That's what he wrote. In Mertens of Murder, he said, I don't have time to read it, but I'm going to read you the last things. طاب منزلك في الأرض والجنة طبت وطاب مسعاك ونسأل الله بعدك الصدق والثبات والإخلاص وحسبنا الله نعم الوكيل. بفقدانك فتحت جرحا عميقا سبقتنا وفزت بإذن الله. Just 1 month passed. Dr. Abul Bara got killed in Castillo, on the Castillo Road. So it's Shaheed, Yan'i Shaheed. Or actually, physicians Shaheed, Yan'i physicians Shaheed. We lost both. So, you know, our hands are tight. But when we go there, that's what we see on the walls. So, we'll stay here. These people will stay here. You know, 850,000 people in Ghouta, in East Ghouta, didn't leave. They're going to stay there. We need to support them. You know, we believe in victory. When I see the eyes of these kids, beautiful kids, they let me believe there is a victory, inshallah. We work all together with all our organizations across the world under the umbrella of USIM. We believe that's Yadullahi Ma'a Jama'a. You know, Everything you do is like the droplets in the lake that create circle after circle after circle. You think it might not do anything, but it does a lot. Thank you very much.